Right now, it's an honor to be joined by the CEO of Sony Computer Entertainment America, Jack Tretton. JT, good to see you, man. Lost the tie today, right?
Yeah, you put one eye, took one off.
Hey, yeah, well, it was, it's great. It's E3. You know, congratulations on a great briefing yesterday. We had to wait a little while for it to get started, but it was well worth the wait, I think.
Takes a long time to get 6,000 people in there, Geoff. But I apologize for the late.
It's all good. It was worth the wait. I mean, you started with Uncharted 3, and before that, you know, you addressed PSN, which I thought was, you know, was a great way to sort of start the briefing, to sort of address your consumers. And, you know, you had your press there, you had your retailers, but talk to the real people that were affected by that. And that was something that came from the heart, right? That wasn't on the script?
No, not at all. And that was really important to me, not only to have the opportunity to address people, but to do it from the heart. And I was, you know, glad to have the opportunity finally, because I felt for everybody out there.
Absolutely. Well, no, it's we're glad we're sort of moving past that. I mean, do you have anything to say to the people that were involved in that, though? I mean, you addressed the consumers, you addressed the press, but you didn't address the people that, you know, hacked into the system.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I don't know what people... I prefer to focus on the people that enjoy playing games. I mean,
yes.
Those are the people that matter to me.
Absolutely.
I guess there's a lot of hobbies out there. There's just not all of them that I can relate to.
Not all constructive, exactly.
Right, right.
All right. Well, you had a great lineup of software yesterday, leading off with Uncharted 3. You know, that's been my most anticipated game for E3. Every time you guys show that, we see something new, we see something, you know, we've never seen before. We're looking at some of the footage now of this game. Tell me a bit about, you know, what this game means to Sony, because it seems like this is really your flagship franchise right now.
Well, there are a lot of superlatives you throw out there, and people say cinematic gaming experience, but it almost embarrasses me that I enjoy watching Uncharted 3 almost as much as I enjoy playing it. I mean, it is just such a great experience, and there's so much going on that it's really blurring the lines between reality and, you know, I think we've said that for years in this industry, but I think even somebody who's not a gamer would have to look at that and go, wow. What the heck is that?
Well, and you said yesterday something that I think is true. When you look at this game, it's not only exclusive to PS3, it's only possible on PS3.
No question about that. And I think built from the ground up to take advantage of the features that we're putting in there. And the guys were telling me that they shoot the shots from as much distance as possible when they're designing the sets and everything, so that when 3D is incorporated in there, it adds the depth, as opposed to 3D being brought in the middle of the processor at the end, built from the ground up for 3D. Just functionality is something that these guys are thinking about, as well as an incredibly compelling storyline.
Now, talk to me a bit about 3D, because that's obviously a corporate initiative for Sony. You know, there's a lot of talk in the movie business about how 3D, there might have been a bit of a bubble that started to burst with that. You have a new 3D TV that you're bringing out for PlayStation with this cool split-screen feature using glasses. How important is 3D to PS3 going forward? Have you sort of scaled back your commitment to 3D, or are you guys pushing forward in a big way?
It's stronger than ever, and I would tell you that personally I'm on board, and I got on board last year when Steven Spielberg came to our booth, and I said, just between you and I, what's the deal with 3D? And he said, oh, we have to work together to make 3D successful, because it gives us an ability to create movies and entertainment experiences like never before.
Right.
And I've had the same conversation with our developers. I mean, if you get a chance to play a true 3D game, it's a game-changing experience, and it reminds me of what it was like when you first started playing PlayStation games back in the mid-90s and really got 3D depth for the first time in gaming.
Absolutely. Well, Uncharted looks great in 3D. You've also, you know, got a big launch coming up later this year with the PS Vita, which is your new handheld platform. In the briefing, you guys announced a price, which I think everyone was impressed with, $249 or $299 with 3G. Now, that's going to be coming out in America by the end of the year, this holiday season?
Yeah, I think, you know, we're looking to get all three regions out by the end of the fiscal year, and I was just so excited to get specifics out there, because I think we're talking a lot of features, but, you know, people need to get their head around what type of investment they need to make and then look at the content and make a decision for themselves. But I think the reaction to the price was extremely positive, so I was really really excited about that.
Now, when you say fiscal year, does that mean calendar year by end of December or end of March?
We're on a March 31st fiscal.
So it may not be out by this holiday in America?
Not in all regions, no.
Okay, and we'll hear more about that later this summer, I guess?
Yeah, I think, you know, production capacity and demand will have everything to do with what our regional rollout strategy is.
But is it still at least one region by the end of this calendar year?
We will have Japan out by the end of the year.
Okay, all right, well, we'll hear more about that. But obviously a lot of great software for that as well, too. And then, you know, you guys have been throwing some really interesting surprises in there. Ken Levine coming out saying they're going to make a BioShock for NGP. You've got Call of Duty saying that they're going to make an NGP title. When are we? The Call of Duty title, is that something we're going to hear more about in the future? Because I think the fans, you know, love that franchise.
Absolutely. I think we've got a great relationship with publishers, but I think we've earned it. And we've said to them, take a look at this technology. It allows you to differentiate your games. We realize you're multi-platform supporters, but let's take advantage of what PlayStation 3 and Vita brings to the table. And the great news is the development community is responding and giving us really meaty examples of product differentiation.
Yeah, I had a chance to play it a little before E3, and it's amazing how light it is. I mean, the screen is beautiful. It's a great handheld platform, so I can't wait to hear.
I brought one along with me, and that's the biggest key is you know, you really got to get your hands on it.
Yep.
And describing it, seeing it on TV is awesome, but it's people getting hands-on experience, and that was a great thing. I'm glad 6,000 people got to touch it last night, but I wish everybody watching at home would eventually
get we've got a demo, I think, coming up. John Kohler's going to be here to take us through some of the amazing games for this. So, yeah, we can't wait to hear more about Vita. Now, one thing that I ask you about every year at E3 is Agent from Rockstar. We've been talking about this for 5-6 years. You guys showed a logo a few years ago. Is that still in development? What's going on with that?
Well, I would tell you, first and foremost, that the guys at Take-Two and Rockstar Games are great partners of ours, and we prayed it out, a lot of great content and relationships with them. And, you know, the relationship with Rockstar goes back a long way, and obviously the success of Grand Theft Auto. So, you know, it's probably a better question for the the Rockstar guys, but Agent is in development. We still have every intention of working closely together, but the specifics
still exclusive to PS3, though?
I'm not sure where we're going to end up on that. Again, that's probably a better question for Rockstar. But I think we'll be very pleased with the PS3 offering on Agent when it comes to market.
Fantastic. Well, it's good to hear that it's still coming out. I got to say, you know, good briefing, some great games, Jack, and good momentum. And I guess we're a few minutes away from Nintendo here, so I'm sure you'll be watching, too, to see what the competitors have, right?
Well, I mean, at the end of the day, I'm a fan of the industry, and I root for everybody to be successful because I do believe the rising tide lifts all boats. And we get a lot of people that were telling me in the 80s that we're all going to be playing games on PCs exclusively, and now people are telling me that people just want to play Angry Birds on a smartphone, but I think there's a few gamers out there that might have a little
bit of interest. When you see that, so those water effects in Uncharted, you're like, that's something I probably want to play.
Yeah, I you know, I'd love to see that on a smartphone, but it's not going to happen in my lifetime.
Probably not, but maybe on Vita. All right, well, Jack, we'll leave it there. Thank
Pleasure,
you so
Jeff.
Much. Always great seeing you at E3.